Thank you. That concludes the debate on Levelling Up and Regeneration Bill UK legislation. It's time to move on to the next item of business, which is an announcement by the Equalities, Human Rights and Civil Justice Committee on inquiry into the human rights of asylum seekers in Scotland. And I call on CoCab Stewart, convener of the committee, to make the announcement.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm grateful to have the opportunity to make this announcement on behalf of the Equalities, Human Rights and Civil Justice Committee. The committee has today published its report on its inquiry into human rights of asylum seekers in Scotland. We began oral evidence on the 25th of April, which was in fact my first meeting as convener of the committee, and continued throughout May and June. Paragraphs 65 to 71 of our report set out who the committee heard from, and we are extremely grateful to all those who contributed to the inquiry, but I particularly want to thank the asylum seekers and refugees who spoke directly to us in our engagement sessions. It was essential to me that we heard the lived experience, which was often traumatic, in order that we as a committee understood clearly the significant challenges that face asylum seekers and refugees. I would encourage members to read the notes from our engagement sessions, which are published on our webpage. They provide a very telling picture of the conditions that asylum seekers face. We hope our report gives a voice to those experiences that have informed our conclusions and our recommendations. We sadly heard about substandard, inappropriate and inadequate conditions, especially around accommodation, which presented an increased risk of being a victim to crime and or exploitation, as well as the increased risk of developing or exacerbating physical and mental health issues. We heard also the support or access to ESOL classes is inconsistent and there is a lack of quality interpreters. English language teaching is essential to help asylum seekers arriving into Scotland integrating into our communities, so it needs to be addressed. There is also a significant reliance on the third sector, as asylum seekers therefore rely on them for clothing, accessing transportation, education, medical, community, religious and cultural facilities. On concessionary travel, I know that the convener of the Citizens Participation and Public Petitions Committee has raised this with the First Minister directly. I also note that Paul Sweeney's members' debate later on this week, which I look forward to contributing in an individual capacity. On behalf of the committee, I want to take this opportunity to acknowledge the incredible work of all the third sector organisations who help asylum seekers find their place in our communities. Whilst immigration is a reserved matter, our report challenges the Scottish Government to make use of the full extent of its existing powers to support and protect asylum seekers. Amongst our recommendations, we challenge the Scottish Government to ensure that the third sector can benefit from improved resourcing, honour its commitment to maintain and enhance the well-being of children in local authorities, maintain and enhance the anti-trafficking protections, and ensure that asylum seekers understand their rights by providing them with accessible education and information. In conclusion, we look forward to a committee debate which we hope to secure before the end of the year, and we look forward to the response of the Scottish Government in advance of that debate. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you. We move to the next item of business, and there are four questions to be put as a result of today's business. And the first is that Amendment 10915.1 in the name of Tess White, which seeks to amend Motion 10915 in the name of Jenny Minto on transvaginal mesh, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.